The day has finally arrived to give this a shot. I have been afraid of making this kind of video for a while because I just didn't think you guys would really care or like it. But I do get asked a lot of questions about this. What are your settings? What are the best settings to hear people, to see people? Especially with a game that has kind of crappy visibility, I understand how it can be hard to notice things. So I hope I can help you. Not everything I'm going to go over is going to be useful for console players. I do want to say that because, frankly, I'm playing on PC. A lot of tryhard players play on PC as well with controller. So these are PC settings, but some of them probably can be useful for you on console. Okay, some of them. Firstly, I'm going to go over audio settings because this is extremely important. And a lot of these things probably won't be useful for console. So you can kind of skip this if you want. If you want to listen, you can. Audio in general, I think home theater is the best. Personally, I know a lot of people like to play with like headphone bass boost. In general, the sensitive stuff that you want to hear, like a reload sound or footsteps, are not covered very well in this. And additionally, it kind of boosts the explosions and gunshots more, where it's not very helpful. I also like to set pretty much everything down to zero for like gameplay music, cinematic music. Voice chat, I do have turned up for video purposes. You can turn this down. Effects are maxed out. You always want your effects maxed out. And your dialogue is kind of half whatever. You can do whatever with this. It's not a big deal. I wouldn't turn up all the way, but dialogue can be useful because your announcer sometimes gives you in-game cues of important stuff. I have master volume turned down a few points just because I don't want things to peak and like, you know, hit the maximum amount. So those are your best in-game audio settings, in my opinion. Additionally, I have a good headset and I have a mixer outside that you can't see. It's just your standard Astro mixer and it's set to tournament mode. But you can have any variety that you like that helps boost up treble, T-R-E-B-L-E, treble, right? That's gonna be your reload sounds, your footsteps. Additionally, on PC, we have something called audio equalization or sound EQ. And you can go under your sounds. You can see this, right? Yeah, okay. And you go to whatever your playback is going to be. Mine is my Elgato, right? You go to properties, enhancements, and you can turn on loudness equalization. You can go a step further and make the release time shorter. I have it turned down 1 point. This basically just boosts the loudness of quiet things. It is a little weird to get used to. It is definitely better at Soundwhoring. Do you need this to succeed? No. I had this off for half the year of Modern Warfare 2, had no problems. But you can hear dead silence with it. If they get close enough, you will hear it, and it is noticeable. So if you want the best, loudest setting, yeah, most people will be using that if they're tryhards. They have that turned on. So that is your sound settings. Next, I want to go to video settings. A lot of people have problems seeing people in, like, seeing opponents in the game. Trust me, you're not alone. One thing you can do if you're on PC is to turn up your color. You can go to control panel, let it load, whatever it takes. Go back. Don't do that. Come back. Where'd it go? Oh, it's over there. I was like, where the hell did it go? And for example, you can go to your, is it change resolution? Where is it at? No, that's my resolution. Color settings. There we go. And you can set your brightness and your contrast, your gamma, your digital vibrance. You can turn this up or down. This makes things brighter or more, you know, just pops more. It pops more. And that's helpful. And a lot of games that honestly have bad visibility. This was a major, major feature that people always would turn up and use back in like H1Z1. If you watched, a lot of people had really bright, bright games. I don't go that far, but I do like the game to look good. And I do like being able to spot people. That will help you. Additionally, you can just alter your monitor settings or your TV settings. A lot of TVs nowadays or monitors, you can just go into the settings themselves and turn up certain features that you want. Again, contrast, your saturation, whatever it might be. So you don't have to change. If you're on console, you can't use that feature, right? The NVIDIA control panel. You can just change your actual monitor or TV settings. That'll help you. Let's go under the important ones though, shall we? The graphics. I have mine set to full screen borderless right now. You never want this, by the way. If you're on PC, you always want full screen exclusive. It gives you more frame rate. I just have it for this video because it lets me tab in and out without causing the Elgato to black screen for a second. So it's just for your guys' viewing pleasure. Besides that, going down, you can turn on and boost for NVIDIA reflex low latency. It's not a huge deal. Eco mode preset. I have it set to custom because I'm doing a lot of different things in here. Up to you again. custom frame rate limit. You really don't need to set this. If you want to let it go max, you can, like I do. But my maximum is pretty much the same as my monitor's refresh rate. A monitor refresh rate is going to be like, you know, 1 millisecond response time plus the hertz. Like the hertz is your 244. It's a 244 FPS monitor. That's the end goal, right? Essentially. So mine, I get about 250 to 280, maybe 300 max. So I don't really limit it. There's no reason to. If you have a really, really good computer and you're only using a 144 hertz monitor, you could limit your frame rate to like 200. And it wouldn't be bad. There's no downside to it for you. Going over to quality. This is a big one. I'm actually going to load into a game so I can show the difference for you guys. Because this is a huge, huge difference when it comes to how clear things are. All right, now that we're in the game, before I continue here, before I give you those settings, under your view section, turn off world motion blur, turn off weapon motion blur, turn off the film grain. Make sure that your camera is set to 50% in terms of like shakiness when you're shot or anything happens. All that stuff is good. If you like inverted flashbang, you can use it. I don't. It's up to you. That's really a preference thing. In terms of your FOV, I prefer affected. I think it's better. I also like 105. I don't really like going max FOV. You can if you like that. It's totally fine. It's a personal preference thing. I don't think you need any more than 105. And the more you zoom out, the more further things seem away. It is a little hard to spot people if they're smaller, you know? So that's just my point of view on that one. Additionally, you can see, God, that is actually really annoying being next to these little things with electricity going. Let me go over here. All right. So you can see it's rather clean. It's definitely bright enough. You see the colors, it's sharp. Here's the difference. This is probably one of the most important settings in the game. Your fidelity CAS. Let's say you wanted to turn on, like, I don't know, NVIDIA DLSS. You're gonna notice the edges get smoothed out. It's a little bit blurrier at distance. A lot of the other settings, they just have this problem. And granted, it is to help you improve your frame rate. I just don't like it. So like, even if you put on NVIDIA image scaling, let me see what this one looks like. It's kind of the same thing. You know, it smooths the edges out, which isn't bad. It's okay, but it's definitely not gonna be as clean. And so I always prefer fidelity CAS. I have mine turned up to 50%. You can turn it up to 100% if you want to. It's very, very sharp at 100%. I don't think that's necessary. I think that there should be a little bit of smoothing to it, but not a lot. So I kind of like the 50 to 60 range. And it just makes things, it sharpens the edges, but it also makes it still pretty visible and in good quality. That is one of the most important settings in the game, in my opinion. I really do believe that. Going past that though, depth of field is off, texture resolution. A lot of this stuff for me is not set to the highest quality. It's not for the highest frame rate or highest quality. It's kind of 50-50 because I want things to look good for the videos themselves. You can just kind of slow this down if you want to. If you find some of these settings are high for you that you don't want or need, turn them down. It's totally fine, you know? You can turn some of these down. If you want more frame rate, you have a less powerful computer, that's totally okay. No issue at all. Turn them down. But I would not alter the upscaling and sharpening at all. Your render resolution, you can leave at 100. If you have a really, really beefy computer, you can turn it up. But if you're ever playing in 1440p like I am right now, it's really not noticeable. It's not. So I wouldn't mess with that at all. I think that about covers everything, though, for graphics and audio, for visibility and audibility. But there are still a few settings left. If you play on keyboard and mouse, you know that like the game has a really weird, like, Excel, decel, floatiness to like the aim. It's really hard to aim on keyboard and mouse. It doesn't seem very consistent. And so there are a couple settings I have enabled. Here are mine personally. I play 800 DPI. I have a 4 in game sense. A few multipliers I change there. Nothing really on the sensitivity multiplier. I play legacy on my sensitivity type and going down to mouse calibration. This is what I turn things on. I turn on mouse smoothing and I turn on mouse filtering up to 2. Don't ask me how this works. I really don't know. I have all those same settings on like every game technically. And for some reason, MW2 and MW3, they both have really weird mouse controls. It doesn't feel right. So these have helped me though. These kind of make it feel a bit more consistent. So I don't have a good answer as to why, but they do. As far as controller goes, I have... Gosh, what is it? Where is it at? I play really low sensitivity, 4-4-9. Your sense doesn't matter. That's your custom, like, what you feel is good. But in terms of what most of the pros recommend, dynamic aim response curve, instant transition timing, Black Ops aim assist. Those are your three big ones. I mean, that is very consistent. If you play a lot of controller, that's your main input, you can mess around with your custom sensitivities, presume. Since I don't play a lot, I don't worry about it, but I can see how this would be very helpful if you did. So, that is the keyboard and mouse and controller settings. Everything else was there. I mean, it's the best I can give you. Best visibility. I'm hoping they still try to improve visibility in the game. They have that experimental playlist they're like testing right now. That could go into a full effect in all modes, but I guess we just have to wait and see. Who knows how long that could be if they even do it. So, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, if this helped, please drop a sub, drop a like. I do appreciate it. And yeah, until next time.